Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. The problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the third practice test, right? Practice test 3, problem number 15, section 3, no calculator. And this practice test is found in the new SAT study guide, right? Released by College Board, which is meant to prepare you for the redesigned SAT that will start from March of 2016, in 3 months' time from now. Okay, so let's see. So they give you an equation that models temperature C measured in degrees Celsius in terms of temperature Fahrenheit, right? Temperature measured in degrees Fahrenheit. So based on the equation, they're saying which of the following must be true. So they're giving you three statements and they're asking you to check each of them to see which one makes sense. So let's check statement one. So statement one says that a temperature increase of 1 degree Fahrenheit is equivalent to a temperature increase of 5/9 degree Celsius, right? 5/9 degree Celsius. So let's see. So a temperature increase means that we're going to add 1 degree to the value of F, right? So the value of F is simply F, and the new F will be F plus 1, right? And that's exactly what I show here. So we're checking statement 1. We're rewriting the equation for C, right? The equation for C, the temperature in degrees Celsius, in terms of temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. So we're going to have 5/9 F plus 1, because we're increasing the temperature in Fahrenheit, in degrees Fahrenheit, by 1 degree. So we're going to have F plus 1 minus 32. And then we take this one out, but remember, when you take this one out, you're going to have to multiply it to 5/9. So we're going to have 5/9 multiplying F minus 32, just like in the given equation. But also now we're going to have 5/9 increase. And then we can substitute in the final value, the left expression as C, because this is what a C equals, right? 5/9 times F minus 32 is the value of C. So we can see what happened to the new C, right? The new C, the temperature in degrees Celsius, increases by 5/9. So in other words, when you increase the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit by 1 degree, it means that you will increase the temperature in degrees Celsius by 5/9 of a degree. Okay, and that's exactly what statement 1 reads. So we checked statement 1 and it's absolutely correct. Let's check statement 2. But before you check for statement 2, you have to understand what this statement means. It says a temperature increase of 1 degree Celsius is equivalent to a temperature increase of 1.8 degrees Fahrenheit. So now they're asking you to express, they're asking you to see what will happen when you increase temperature in degrees Celsius by 1 degree. So that means that temperature in degrees Fahrenheit will be a function of the temperature in degrees Celsius. And as soon as you realize that, it means that you have to rewrite the equation, the given equation, in terms of C, right? So you're going to express F in terms of C, because right now C, temperature in degrees Celsius, is expressed in terms of the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, but you have to rewrite it so that your variable C is the independent variable and the F is the dependent variable, right? Because this is what the statement 2 calls for. It says the temperature increase of 1 degree Celsius, right? So it says if something happened to Celsius, what will happen to degrees Fahrenheit, right? So you have to rewrite. So when you rewrite, you're gonna multiply both sides by 9. So you're gonna have 9C is equal to 5 times F minus 32. And then you're gonna divide that, this result, by 5, right? So you're gonna have 9 times C plus 1. Went forward here. So you're going to have 9 times C divided by 5 plus 32, right? Because you're going to, after you multiply both sides by 9 and divided both sides by 5, you will have added 32, right? So you add 32 on both sides as your final operation before you isolate the f, variable f, right? So when you do that, the f will equal 9 times c divided by 5 plus 32, okay? So now you're ready to check statement 2, right? So now you're ready to increase the temperature in Celsius by 1 degree. You're going to increase it, right? So you're going to do the same thing we did for statement 1. You're going to increase C by 1. So this is going to be the new temperature in Celsius, right? The increased temperature by 1 degree Celsius. So it's going to be C plus 1 divided by 5 plus 32. And again, you can take out the 1, but make sure that it multiplies the 9 and then divides by 5, right? Because it's still part of the fraction. So it's going to be 9 times C divided by 5 plus 32 plus 9 fifths, right? Because 9 is still divided by 5 and we took it out and it's going to be 9 fifths there added. So now we're ready to substitute 9 times C divided by 5 plus 32, which was in our derived equation for F, and that equaled F, right? So 9 times C divided by 5 plus 32 is the value of F. So we substitute it back to F. So F will be added to 9 fifths. So in other words, 9 fifths will be added to F when we add 1 to C. Okay? So what happens? So when a temperature increase happens, a temperature increase of 1 degree for Celsius, what will happen to the temperature increase of Fahrenheit, right? So how's the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit will increase when we increase the temperature in degrees Celsius by 1, right? It will be 9 fifths increase, okay? And that's absolutely correct, because 9 over 5 is the same thing as 1.8, right? Because we know that 1 fifth is 0.2, so when you multiply this by 9, 0.2 times 9 will be 1.8, right? So 1.8 and 9 over fifths is the same thing. This is a decimal answer and this is a fractional answer, right? So statement 2 must be correct as well. Now for statement 3, we can go back to the original equation, right? Because it calls for what will happen to degrees Celsius when there's a change in degrees Fahrenheit. So it says a temperature increase of 5/9 degrees Fahrenheit is equivalent to a temperature increase of 1 degree Celsius, right? So we can use this original equation again. So we're going to add 5/9 for the F, for the new F, for the new temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. So we can take it out again, and we're going to have 5/9 times F minus 32 plus, and remember that 5/9 multiplies itself, so it's squared, so it's going to be 25 over 81. So we substitute this value on the left back to C, because this is the original equation, right? C is equal to 5/9 times F minus 32. So C will be changed. The new temperature in Celsius will be increased by 25/81 of a degree Celsius. Okay, and that's not what you see here, because it says an increase of 1 degree Celsius. So this statement is incorrect. All right? So only statements 1 and 2, answer choice D.